Holy Ghost.
As it was.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Do not put the Lord your God to the test, as you tested him at Massah. You must diligently keep the commandments of the Lord your God and his decrees and his statutes that he has commanded you. Do what is right and good in the sight of the Lord, so that it may go well with you, and so that you may go in and occupy the good land that the Lord swore to your ancestors to give you, thrusting out all your enemies from before you, as the Lord has promised. When your children ask you in time to come, "What is the meaning of the decrees and the statutes and the ordinances that the Lord our God has commanded you?" Then you shall say to your children, "We were Pharaoh's slaves in Egypt, but the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand. The Lord displayed before our eyes great and awesome signs and wonders against Egypt, against Pharaoh and all his household. He brought us out from there in order to bring us in, to give us the land that he promised on oath to our ancestors. Then the Lord commanded us to observe all these statutes, to fear the Lord our God for our lasting good, so as to keep us alive, as is now the case. If we diligently observe this entire commandment before the Lord our God, as he has commanded us, we will be in the right." Here ends the lesson.
Thank you. reading from John. Then they took Jesus from Caiaphas to Pilate's headquarters. It was early in the morning. They themselves did not enter the headquarters so as to avoid ritual defilement and to be able to eat the Passover. So Pilate went out to them and said, "What accusation do you bring against this man?" They answered, "If this man were not a criminal, we would not have handed him over to you." Pilate said to them, "Take him yourselves and judge him according to your law." The Jews replied, "We are not permitted to put anyone to death." This was to fulfill what Jesus had said when he indicated the kind of death he was to die. Then Pilate entered the headquarters again, summoned Jesus, and asked him, "Are you the King of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you ask this on your own, or did others tell you about me?" Pilate replied, "I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom is not from this world. If my kingdom were from this world, my followers would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not from here." Pilate asked him, "So you are a king?" Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." Pilate asked him, "What is truth?" After he had said this, he went out to the Jews again and told them, "I find no case against him." Here ends the lesson.
Thank you. Forgive me for calling an audible this evening. There is no homily printed in your bulletin. But as you look at the front cover, you'll see that this is the Feast of Absalom Jones Choral Evensong. And as this parish's first black priest, I could not keep my seat, because I stand on the shoulders of Absalom Jones. I am here today because he lived. This church is better because he lived, because he had the courage to stand before white folks who called themselves Christian in his day, but refused to affirm his humanity, his belovedness in the face of Jesus Christ, and said, I am. And what's more, I am called to serve this God who exists in free love, this God who binds us all together as one, who saved us in the person of Jesus Christ. Forgive me, I could not keep my seat. To do so would have been irresponsible and disrespectful. I stand here tonight because Absalom Jones lived courageously, faithfully, refused to accept the moniker of slave. And before he bought his own freedom, purchased the freedom of his wife, who did even better than he preached. So I stand before you celebrating this feast today, mindful of what it means for me, for you, for this place, determined to take up the prayer intoned in the Black National Anthem, God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who has brought us thus far on the way, thou who has by thy might led us into the light, keep us forever in the path we pray, lest our feet stray from the places, our God, where we met thee, lest our hearts, drunk with the wine of the world, we forget thee, shadowed beneath thy hand. May we forever stand true to our God, forgive my amendment here, determined to take a stand. Determined to take a stand for freedom and justice and equality. Determined to take a stand until all the world rings out with the unconditional love, forgiveness, grace, mercy, and reconciliation that Jesus embodied. May that be our prayer. May we take it up as our mission, along with the mission that we hope to incarnate in this place, to open hearts to God and doors to community as we leave this place. Anything less, friends, is unacceptable. Amen. Please.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified,
Thank you.
Let us pray the general thanksgiving together. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, thine unworthy servants, do give thee most humble and hearty thanks for all thy goodness and loving kindness to us and to all men. We bless thee for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for thine inestimable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we beseech thee, give us that due sense of all thy mercies, that our hearts may be unfeignedly thankful, and that we show forth thy praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to thy service, and by walking before thee in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen.